Hello students, welcome to English class. Today in this class we are going to deal with a very interesting topic about fans. Mystery of the talking fan, secret of the talking fan. You all have seen ceiling fans like this. I have taken away the blades, the three blades of this fan. But this kind of fans installed in your room, installed in your house, have a lot of secret to tell to you. So if you notice, if I move this fan like this, I can hear something. So this fan is trying to tell me something, tell me, convey to me some message. So what this fan is trying to tell me is what this poem is going to describe to us. Let us see what does this poem, what does the fan have secret to convey to us. If you see in the beginning of the poem, the poet, is there a ceiling fan in the room where you are sitting now? Yes, you are sitting above your head, above you, over your head, you can see that there are ceiling fans. Is the fan quiet or noisy? All these fans are noisy. They have something to tell to us. If it is noisy, you may be sure it is a distant relative of the talking fan. So if it is noisy like this, if it is making a sound like this, these fans are relatives of this talking fan. Which you are going to read. So about this talking fan, we are going to read what it is going to tell. What is the secret of this kind of a fan? So, the poet. Who is the poet? Maud Rubin. Maud Rubin tells that once there was a talking fan, electrical his chatter. Once upon a time, he says that there was a talking fan like this and he made some electrical chatter. He made some electrical sound. If you switch on the fan, the fan made some electrical sound. Without electricity, no sound. When you switch on the fan, it made some electrical chatter. It made some electrical sound. I could not quite hear what he said, and I hope it doesn't matter. The fan was telling me, hello, can you listen to me? Hello, I want to tell you something. But I did not listen, and the fan also did not matter. Like this, the process was going on. The fan was telling me, despite giving me a lot of air, the fan did not complain. He simply was telling, but I did not listen and he did not matter. Because one day somebody oiled another equipment, if I oil it like this, if I oil the fan like this, somebody oiled this noisy fan with this instrument, with this oiling instrument, somebody oiled his little violin meter. The moving motor, the wheeling motor was oiled by someone, by some electrician, by some plumber, by some mechanic. It was oiled. And once it was oiled, and all the mystery was spoiled. When somebody oiled it, when somebody put some oil in the moving motor of the fan, the sound, the secret, the mystery of the fan was gone because it stopped making any noise after somebody oiled it. So, and all the mystery, all the secret, all the things the fan was telling me was gone. He ran as still as water. If I put this water here, no sound. The fan, in the same way, ran as still as water. The way the water ran very smoothly, very silently. In the same way, the fan moved very silently after it was oiled by the mechanic. There was no sound, but previously the motor of the fan was trying to convey to me some message. Actually, the message was that, hello friend, please give me some oil. I need some oil. And the electrician perhaps understood the message of the fan and he oiled the motor. After it was oiled, the fan started making or stopped making any noise. Now, if we try to find out the poetic devices used in this poem, we find that there are two main poetic devices used here. Number one is personification. What is personification? It is a poetic device where a thing, a non-living thing like this is given human-like qualities. The way the fan is trying to say something, the fan is trying to speak something like a human being, this is an example of personification. The fan is asking for oil, I am hungry, my parts are dry, please give me some oil. This is a example, this is an example of personification. And the next, the poetic device that the poet uses here is rhyme scheme. So if you see chatter, matter, motor, water, these are rhyming. So if we regard this, if we try to find out the rhyme scheme of this particular poem, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 lines, then we will find that if we regard this fan as A, then chatter as B, then again B, then motor B, water B. Then, if we regard this saint as C, saint C, oil C, spoil C. How to find out the rhyme scheme? Go to the last word of the line. Fan, not a single last word in this poem rhymes with fan. So let us take A here. Chatter, if we take B, now let us see if there is any word, last word in the poem that rhymes with chatter. Yes, matter is rhyming with chatter, motor is rhyming with matter, water is rhyming with motor. So, B, 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 A, B, 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 B. Then if we regard this C, then C, C, C. So, A, B, C, B, C, B, C, B. This is the rhyme scheme of the poem. Second poetic device that is being used in the poem. Now let us come to some of the questions used here. So if we see the second question, the chatter is electrical because the fan is making the sound only when the electricity is put or switched on. That's why the chatter is electrical. When the fan is not moving before being oiled by the mechanic, it was not making any chattering, it was not making any sound. So electrical, the sound was purely electrical because only being applied with electricity, the sound was heard. It was mysterious because nobody could understand what the fan was demanding. And once the mechanic understood and oiled the fan using this, the fan started moving very swiftly, making no sound. So what do you think the fan was demanding? Obviously, oil. And is there a talking fan in your house? Yes. Create a dialogue aeronautic students, my dear students, this is a homework, home assignment for you. Please try to develop a dialogue where the fan and you or a mechanic is talking. If the fan, you just make an inspection of all the ceiling fans of your house and try to find out whether any fan is making or trying to share some mystery. And if it is trying to share some secret, try to make a dialogue between that fan. And I am sure that some of your fans, two or three of your fans in your house, is definitely trying to say something to you. Try to find it out, and I hope that all of you have understood this poem called The Mystery of Talking Fan, Secret of Talking Fan, and I am very sure that all of you have solved the mystery of this talking fan. You have clearly understood what was the secret of this particular talking fan. Thank you, and I hope that you all have understood. Thank you, all of you.